हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी लर्न रिगार्डिंग ऑपरेशन थिएटर। टॉपिक स्टार्ट करने से पहले मैं कहना चाहूँगी कि अगर आपको मेरा ये वीडियो पसंद आए तो प्लीज़ इसे लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूले। आज हम लोग ऑपरेशन थिएटर के बारे में, उसके इंट्रोडक्शन, प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ ओटी एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ओटी एंड जोनल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन आज हम लोग देखेंगे। इंट्रोडक्शन। An operating theatre, it is also known as an operating room, operating suite, an operation theatre or operation suite is a facility within a hospital where surgical operations are carried out in a sterile environment. Now, principles used in design of operation theatre. First principle includes, it is in a simple and easy design. Then wall and floor are smooth and made of non-porous materials. Then, to prevent cross-contamination, every person who enter in the operation theatre, they must wear the cap, mask and gloves and gown to prevent the cross-infection in a patient. Then, sufficient space is needed in an operation theatre. Then, the layout should be convenient for the supervisor. Then, the recovery room near the operating room is there. Easy access to departments like ICU, CSSD and surgical ward is near the operating room. Now, the location and size of OT. The OT theater in a hospital should be at a centralized location. An ideal general surgery operation theater may have minimum clear area of 360 square feet. However, specialized OT such as cardiothoracic, orthopedic and neurosurgery may require still larger areas. Now, physical setup of the operating room includes supervisor's office. It has direct access to the outside of the operating room. The supervisor may need to receive visitors and significant others who are not dressed in a scrub attire. Then, male or female dressing rooms includes for operating room personnel have a door to the outside corridors so that personnel may enter there, change into scrub attire and go directly into the operating room. Then holding area, it is an area designated for the parking of stretchers with patients awaiting surgery. This is the area where the healthcare givers properly identify the patient and make sure that all preoperative cares are carried out and other important data are in the patient's chart. Then scrub sink areas are located in several places close the operating suites. Scrub brushes, caps, soaps, masks are located at each scrub stations. Now workroom is located so as to be away from the direct traffic of the operating suites. It is divided into two separate areas, one for clean instruments and supplies and one for soiled equipment. Now, sterile supply room. It serves as a supply depot for wrapped sterile articles. These areas will be dusted frequently with a damp cloth and have storage cabinets with doors to minimize exposure of the supplies to room air and dust. Now, storage areas for extra equipment and supplies are used to store these extra instruments and supplies for each unit. Now, recovery room. It has an access to the outside of the operating room for transporting the patients back to their rooms. Now, operating suites are rooms where surgery is performed. These rooms are wide enough to allow scrub personnel to move around non-sterile equipment without their contamination. This is a layout of a ideal OT. Now, operation theatre design. It considering of asepsis promotion required in an OT, it should be designed according to zonal distribution as follows. In a zone 1, it is the outer zone. This zone is comparatively the most unsterile zone. This area includes the changing room, dressing room, patient reception, lockers and refreshment rooms. Upon entry of this area, everyone including the patient should change into OT clothing and slippers. Now, zone 2, it is a middle or intermediate zone. In that, this is a semi-restricted area. This area should be large enough to receive supplies like linen, sterile supplies, portable X-ray machines, etc. These areas should not permit personnel without OT room attire. Mask is not necessary in this area. Now, zone 3, that is the inner or sterile zone. This zone is also called as the restricted area and is the actual operating section of an OT. In this zone, rooms should be located and arranged in such a way that it can be maintained in a sterile condition. This zone includes the scrubbing area with adequate number of sinks with elbow or foot control taps, anesthesia and operating room. It is mandatory to wear the scrub clothes, cap and mask in this zone. So these all are the dividation of a zone in OT. Now, classification of operation theater includes, first, on the basis of extent of surgery involved, OT can be minor OT and major OT. Minor OT, it means like suture taking and other minor surgeries, and major OT, it includes the like major cardiac surgery, major orthopedic surgery, like a knee transplantation. These operations are done in the major OT. Now, second classification is on the basis of types of services provided, that is the outpatient OT and inpatient OT. Outpatient OT may be located in the outpatient department and it involves the surgeries performed on outpatient basis. Usually, they are minor surgeries performed under local anesthesia. Then inpatient OT in a hospital are usually used for inpatients. They are usually located away from the outpatient department. However, some outpatient procedures requiring short stay may be performed in inpatient OT. Now, third classification includes on the basis of sharing of OT, that is decentralized OT. उसमें क्या होता है कि अलग अलग ऑपरेशन के लिए लाइक अ न्यूरो सर्जरी, कार्डियक सर्जरी, ईएनटी सर्जरी, ऑर्थोपेडिक सर्जरी, गायनेक, ओटी, ये सब ओटी का डिवाइडेशन अलग अलग किया जाता है. अलग अलग ऑपरेशन अलग अलग ओटी में किए जाते हैं. और अदर इज द सेंट्रलाइज्ड ओटी. उसमें क्या होता है, ये सारे न्यूरो सर्जरी, कार्डियक सर्जरी, सारे ऑपरेशन के लिए सिर्फ पूरे हॉस्पिटल में एक ही ऑपरेशन थिएटर होता है. नाउ फोर्थ क्लासिफिकेशन इंक्लूड्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ अर्जेंसी ऑफ सिचुएशन इन दैट इमरजेंसी ओटी एंड इलेक्टिव ओटी. इमरजेंसी ओटी आर कंसर्न विद सर्जरीज टू बी परफॉर्म्ड इन केस ऑफ एन इमरजेंसीज. देन इन इलेक्टिव ओटी, दीज आर रेगुलर ओटीज ऑफ ए हॉस्पिटल इन विच द रूटीन प्लान सर्जरीज आर performed as per the list of patients decided at least one day prior to the surgery. Okay, so these all are the classification of a OT. Thank you friends. अगर आपको कोई query हो क्या, आपको कोई भी comment करना हो तो please comment box में जाके comment करें और please मेरे इस channel को like, share and subscribe करना ना भूलें.